And welcome to this bonus edition of Front Row Tampa Bay. We are going to talk about job creation. By the way, we're at Channel Side. We are at StageWorks, just a stone's throw from the Tampa Bay Times Forum, where the Republican National Convention is going on. As many of you know, Governor Rick Scott has made job creation in Florida a top priority. And a man at the point of that effort is Secretary of Commerce Gray Swope, who holds the dual title of Secretary and also President and CEO of Enterprise Florida. Welcome.
Good to see you. Thank you, Frank. I'm glad to be here.
So the challenge is before you, and there are numerous things that have gone on over the past year to achieve this goal of creating more jobs and bringing more business into the state of Florida. And one of those is getting rid of unnecessary regulations to make it a more business-friendly environment, correct?
That's correct. You know, first of all, the value proposition of Florida, you know, doing business here is cost-effective. You talk to our CEOs, you talk to our companies here, it is a place that you can make a profit. It's a good place to do business. But if you talk about ease of doing business, that's what we have to do to grow the economy in Florida. We have to make it easier for a company, whether they want to start up a new business, it's a technology company, whether it's a new business that wants to locate here, we have to make it easier for them to start business here. And so we're really focused on job-killing regulations, doing away with them. This legislative body, we've done away with over 1,500 unnecessary regulations to make it easier to do business in the state.
But you want to strike a balance. In other words, when you get rid of regulations, you want to make sure it's not doing any harm on the other side.
Absolutely. And I tell people that all the time. You know, we're in communities, and when we talk about this, they often think, oh my goodness, we're just doing away with all regulations. No, that's not what we're saying at all. We're saying mitigate the risk. Mitigate the risk that a business has to figure in is what's their timeline to get up and started. So if you look at the permitting process, we've now, with Herschel Vineyard and the Department of Environmental Protection now, is an average of 63 days to get a permit, and they're bringing that down lower every day. And it's okay.
Give me a frame of reference. What was it before?
Sometimes we had some projects that are out there for years waiting to get an answer. And if the answer is no, the answer is no. But if the answer is, look, we can do this, let's expedite it, you tell me as a business what I need to do to get to yes. In an expedited way, in a way that protects the environment, but at the same time that you can mitigate the risk. Probably the greatest example of that is, so you look at Denny's Corporation that's headquartered in Orlando. When they make a decision to locate a new business, a new store, they're going to look at, you know, last year they built 80 new stores in the United States. They probably have 300 sites that they can build those. So where the demographics are right, the real estate's right, the intersection, street intersection's right. Where do you think they're going to make the decision to put those 80 locations? They're going to put those in locations where they have a probability of opening a week earlier versus later. If 40 of them opened up a week earlier, that's 40 weeks of additional revenues to their bottom line. And so companies can make decisions on markets. So if it's a hard place to do business, why would they do business there?
Another inherent problem you found at the state level was you had a number of different economic development entities, and nobody was talking to each other. They were all doing their own thing.
Right.
Is that an accurate depiction?
Absolutely. And again, I look at Governor Scott and the leadership that he's brought to Floridians and in this state, bringing these resources together from day one after he was elected, 20 months ago? From day one after he was elected, he started on saying, look, we're going to work together as one strategy, one team, one that could be effective, efficient, doing more with more efficient use of resources, which is good to taxpayers, but at the same time, it's also good for businesses. So, you know, I'll look at this year alone. We projects that we've worked on together, Department of Economic Opportunity that's not even a year old, Enterprise Florida and our business development team there, Workforce Florida, and also Space Florida, all involved, one project, sharing resources, sharing knowledge, so that Floridians benefit from jobs and new investment.
And then it goes down to the regional and local level as well.
Well, you know, I often tell people all the time that you can have the best state strategy in the world, but the local economic development organizations aren't involved, it'll fail. You know, you can do everything on the state level, but if you don't have the partner that's working with you on the local level, it will not work. So we've reached out to all 67 counties. We look at the primary economic development organizations in those counties. We have a group in Enterprise Florida called the Strategic Partners Division, and we work with that group. We work with our local economic development organizations to strengthen that relationship, help them to be more competitive, coaching, and at the same time, they can help us in being able to deliver a product to customers that are looking at the state of Florida.
And in the end, the local entities really know their area best, do they not?
Absolutely. But, you know, I think that's it's a partnership because as I said, you know, we can sell the state. We work on the business climate of the state. But then again, the regulations that we talked about earlier, the same thing has to be happening on the local level. And so we work with them to help streamline the processes on the local level. And again, it's not the state telling you what to do on the local level. You make those decisions, but we're saying this is how you can be more competitive.
It seems to me if you want to create jobs, you have to concentrate first on keeping the businesses that are here, perhaps encourage them to expand if that's appropriate, and then you're trying to lure businesses, corporation, companies from other locations to come here as well.
Well, first of all, if you're building, and anybody will tell you this in economic development, if you're building a business development strategy and there's not a existing business piece of it, it will fail. Because a new business that's going to come into a location, what are they going to do? They're going to pick up the phone and they're going to say, hey, how have you been treated? And if they haven't been treated well, they're going to say, well, why would I want to move there? And so, yes, it's a key piece of it. And so we look at, you know, the projects that we're working today in Enterprise Florida. The majority of those are existing Florida companies that are wanting to expand here.
Explain your dual role, Enterprise Florida, Secretary of Commerce.
Well, I think that's the beauty of trying to bring all the entities together. So Enterprise Florida, for 16 years, we've been the lead economic development organization for the state from a business development standpoint. So we focused our core mission of job creation, business development, trade, international development, doing the things that are necessary so that we can be competitive in that. Then I wear the dual hat of sitting in Governor Scott's senior leadership as his Secretary of Commerce, that we can get the bigger picture view. So how does Enterprise Florida work with the Department of Economic Opportunity, and how do we have that seamless approach to economic development? So I can talk to Hunt Deutsch, the director of DEO, almost on a daily basis, saying here's where we can work a little closer together, where I could pick up the phone and talk to Herschel Vineyard and say, Herschel, look, we've got a permit that's coming to your shop. Just want to give you a heads up. So you can bring all the resources to the table.
Do different areas of the state, because Florida is, okay, it's one state, but as you go around the state, there are different characteristics in each place. So are certain industries suited to the Jacksonville area versus Miami versus Tampa Bay versus the Panhandle?
Well, you know, each region of the state has its own assets that are competitive assets that may be different than other locations. And certainly with that, you have competitive clusters that come out of that. So when businesses cluster together and there are certain clusters, then yes, you can say that may be one region. But again, we work with our local partners, number one. And what are your local strategies? I mean, what are you trying to do here locally? And then how do we work together? When we have our state strategies that we know that can fit any region of the state, but and on the local level, we'll see where, you know, where they overlap, and then we can really accelerate that.
Educational institutions, our state university system, how important is this in terms of job creation?
Extremely important. I mean, where we're sitting today, the University of South Florida is the second largest holder of U.S. patents in the United States. I mean, they play a huge role. And so certainly from an R&D company, you look in the case of University of Florida recently, a Mindtree locating there and their software development and using engineers there from the University of Florida. You look over on the Space Coast and the university's role with the new engineering design center that Embraer is building there. Universities play a huge role all over the state.
So we have a talented workforce in place for any company who wants to come to the state of Florida?
We have, first of all, you know, companies today, a lot of them will tell you they're hiring on attitude first. And if they have the right attitude.
If you're a go-getter.
You're a go-getter. If you can work with teams, those soft skills, if you have that, then we'll look at what are the pedigree, so to speak. What are the pedigree skills that go with that? And so, yes, we have all of the state, no matter what you're looking for, there is a workforce here that is a pipeline. And in addition, if you want to look at the startup training for a new business coming in, look at Workforce Florida and the things that we're doing there. The U.S. Chamber of Commerce has said it's the number one, you know, workforce training program in the United States. We can get you up to speed and running very quickly.
Entrepreneurs are encouraged and welcome here.
Absolutely. I mean, you look all over the state. It's full of entrepreneurs that have started businesses all over the state. And they're in all kinds of diverse businesses. It's everything that may be connected to the hospitality business. It could be coming out of a university and technology transfer. There's advanced manufacturing here. You look on the Space Coast of people that have worked with NASA and the shuttle program that are now coming out and they're with new ideas of businesses that they're doing.
Brilliant
there.
People with a lot
yeah,
to offer.
Absolutely. Yeah. They're rocket scientists.
All right. Grace Wope is Secretary of Commerce, President and CEO of Enterprise Florida, and he's about to become talk show host. Because you're going to have your CEO roundtable coming up next.
It's a one-day job, I'll assure you.
I know you do great. Yeah. We'll be right back.